and his temple is placed on a terrace above a city. It's a city below us.
Oh, very good. And what does the city look like? Does it look modern, or what does the city look like to you?
No, it seems like it's rather old, small houses and narrow streets.
Well, maybe we'll go down to the city later. And if you look back at the temple, do you see any signs or anything that will tell you what this place is?
There's a sign above a big wooden door, but I can't read the sign. It's strange. It's very strange letters.
And I want you to focus on those big wooden doors. Are there handles on the door?
Two big rings.
Ah, excellent. And I want you to, if you could reach the door, I want you to knock on it. And those doors are open, and I believe that the keeper of this place will come forward. Are the doors opening?
Yes.
And which way are the doors opening? Are they opening in or out?
It's opening in.
Ah, beautiful. And tell me the first thing you see as the doors open.
It's a big hall. Very shiny and sparkly. And it's the same. It seems almost like the same material as the outside, but it's very shiny and glistening,
huh?
Well, yeah.
Let's go ahead and enter in and tell me who's there to greet you. There's a man, you say?
Yes.
Excellent.
But very tall man.
Taller than you, huh?
Yes, quite a bit taller than me. But, and he's smiling and put his hand forward towards me.
Ah, very good. And before you walk toward him, he understands. I want you to just look at yourself and describe yourself. Look at your hands and your feet, and what does your form look like?
I have very pale skin, almost transparent. I'm not short either, but not as tall as that man.
Are you male or female?
I am a male.
And what
I have some kind of footwear that you wrap around your leg, some ribbons to keep them on. Like some kind of ancient sandals or something like that.
Understood. I see that in my mind's eye.
And I have a white cloth around me, in almost feeling like it's made up of silk. Very nice, soft and shiny. And
beautiful. And do you have a human form? Normal hands and...
No, not really. I have very long limbs. I have long arms, long hands, and I'm very slim.
So what do your fingers look like then? Or how many?
I have 3 fingers and a thumb.
Do you recognize this form from before?
Yes, I have seen it before.
Have we done a session before with you in this form? You take a long...
Yes, we have.
Oh, very good. And take
it's, a... It's a form I usually have when I go into a high frequency.
Oh, very good. And go ahead once again for... But touch your head and just the person knows what you're doing, and they know they're probably still smiling while you're checking yourself out.
The man is smiling at me and nodding his head.
Oh, very good. So he knows exactly what you're doing. He knows what we're doing.
Yes, he is aware of us.
And so your ear...
I don't remember that I had hair before, but I have now very long, black, shiny hair.
Ah, interesting.
Yeah, it's very long, almost down to my waist.
If I just ask you, how old are you? How old are you? In linear Earth years.
735.
Oh, very good. And do you have a name?
Thelos.
Very good, Thelos.
Thelos.
Well, let's go ahead and greet the host in this beautiful place. And they have a message for you. Listen to the message and then go ahead and relay it.
You want me to follow him?
Oh, very good then. And let him, go ahead and let him lead you. How does his energy feel?
Wonderful. It feels like a warm blanket I am holding his hand.
Oh, you're very good, sir.
It feels so good, and we almost felt like family.
And as you're walking with him, I want you to just think in your mind, what is his position? And he'll relay it to you, I'm sure, in this place.
He is a keeper of all of the knowledge there is. All of the knowledge that is necessary for us.
Excellent. And if you were to... Actually, let's just see where he takes you. I have a feeling he already knows what you desire without me having to make the suggestion.
He's taking me to a big staircase, also made out of marble.
Oh, very good.
He's taking me up the stairs.
Now, we had questions about what we call here on Earth the Milky Way galaxy, or solar system. No, it's a galaxy, right? Let's just see.
He said you can ask whatever you desire.
Ah, oh, very good.
You're taking me to in front of another door. And he's opening it. It's a double door. Several yards high. it's going out toward this time. And we are standing on a big, big landing. And he's taking me into this room. And there's a lady waiting for me.
Ah, very nice. Your auntie.
She say greetings to you all. We are happy to meet you again. We are prepared to be assistance to you if you so desire.
We are very thankful and grateful to have the opportunity to be here again. And we, of course, are with question and...
We are aware of that mission you are on. And you are more than welcome. That's why we are in front of you now.
Well, we were wondering about our solar system. What we were wondering in our solar system, and possibly, could she first, for the listeners, explain this place that we're in so others who may have a desire to come and explore this amazing place, if they're...
We are visiting in the 11th dimension. We are in the room of the keepers of the knowledge. And here is all information that we could possibly need in our lifetime. It's almost like a big, big library, but no shelf. It's just different area you can access different knowledge. They present it in images, feeling, and speech.
Well, there's so many questions.
There are so enormously big displays, but you can go from one end to another in just a second. So whatever you decide to get to know about, you will be there as soon as you want.
Ah, instantaneously. Well, we're interested in the Milky Way galaxy and the Earth. First, we had a desire to know or to see, when did the moon of the Earth, of Gaia, how did that get there? Can you be shown that, or can they present that to you? We hear that it's an artificial construct and that it was placed there, and because it doesn't rotate, we only see it from one angle, and that's what we were interested in first of all.
Showing me that it was creating at the same time as the Earth, but it has been a place for many races that have visited our solar system. They have been there to be assisting the creation of the planets. So it is not made from some entity, it's made out of the same stuff as everything else in the solar system.
We've been told over and over that it was an artificial construct.
No, it's not, but it's different from many other planetary bodies in your solar system.
What makes it so different? or unique.
Why you perceive it being made or constructed is because it's rather hollow. It's hollow, but it's just that way because of creation of that planet, of that moon. It's nothing artificial about it.
Ah, and you say it was created at the same time of the Earth, and you say there are lots of different extraterrestrials or different beings that have lived on it. Are there beings that still live on it today?
Not permanently, no.
So there are beings that are coming and going.
Yes, they're visiting and staying there for consulting different culture about works that need to be done and help with.
Work pertaining to the Earth?
To the whole of the solar system.
Ah, very good. And why does it not rotate or spin? We only see one side of it always. How is that possible?
It's due to what you call the gravitation field. It's so that the Earth has that mass that it tug on it and help stop its rotation in a fixed place. Even though the moon have a tug on our planet, your planet here, our Gaia, it's impacting that also with its gravitation field. But it's the Earth that has stopped it in rotating billions of years ago.
Wow.
When the moon was much nearer to Earth than.
Oh, it was?
Moving away a little bit all the time because of our path around the sun, and the sun is affecting the order between the bodies in the solar system.
How does that affect the planet Earth as it gradually moves away? Curious.
It don't affect very much because it's so slow and gradual in very small steps. So, but the tidal effect on the planet was much, much larger a couple of billion years ago.
Understood. You said this place has all of the answers. Are there bases on the moon from in our linear expression human beings from the Earth on the surface of the moon or beneath the surface of the moon?
No, there's not any bases from the inhabitants from planet Earth on the moon. There have been some kind of bases, but extraterrestrial.
Ah, understood.
But they are no longer in operation. It's just on temporary use.
So even today, it's used temporarily?
Yes, on and off. And so is many celestial bodies in your solar system.
There's a question that I have to ask. With the technology that we have, we can see that there was an image on are there any pyramids built on that moon? Just curious. Not that I know that. I don't think anyone ever said there was. But are there any pyramid structures on the moon?
No, not any pyramids, but there are structures of the moon that are very ancient and used to support that basis in the past. But they are very, very, very old.
Well, the next planet that are orbital that around our sun that I was interested in was Mars. Mars, what we call it, Mars. Can you see that planet as well?
Yes.
Had there been life on the planet Mars the same way there's life on the planet Earth right now in the past? In our perceived past?
A couple of billion years ago, yes, there was a lot more lush. It was water and vegetation there, but not at all in the same way as on the planet Earth.
What happened? Not at all. What happened to the lushness of the planet?
When the creation of the solar system was going on, there was a lot of collisions of smaller celestial bodies, and the effect was that the atmosphere was almost shaved off the planet. When bigger objects passed it very closely. So the other celestial bodies took the existing atmosphere with it when they passed.
Understood. And were there inhabitants on the planet at that time before this?
There have never been inhabitants as the same way as on the planet Earth. But there has been being living on the planets, but for a shorter amount of times, in different timelines.
Have any of those beings, were they physical beings, physical incarnations?
There have been, yes.
Has any of those particular beings taken refuge or decided to incarnate on the Earth then after that atmosphere or after that catastrophe? What seems like a catastrophe?
Maybe just... No, because they were in a higher frequency and density. So they would not adapt to the planet Earth at that time. So they left for other solar systems.
Understood. There is a an image on the moon, on Mars, that everyone sees. They call it the face on the Mars, and then it seems like there's some pyramids there as well. Are there pyramid structures? When, you know, we see these images on the NASA photos that look like pyramids. Are there pyramid? Are there pyramid structures on that planet? On the
No, there's no structure left that you can perceive. And there is no face, it's just a trick of your imagination and your limited of your brain that you would like to see human features. And you learn that from an early age to recognize a face. And you can see it in almost everything. You see it in a cloud formation,
yes.
You see it in mountain formation, you can imagine it all over, but no, there is no structure left.
Ah, very interesting. And so, are there any bases on Mars right now that have human inhabitants in them from the Earth?
No. Your technology is not enough to have any bases there now.
Very interesting. And you say large bodies of it, once upon a time. So okay, I'll just move to the next planet. I won't. That those are excellent. Thank you. We're very thankful for these answers and a lot, and for you allowing us to see these, allowing Alars to see and experience this amazing place with this an incredible knowledge. Venus is another planet. Are there any, has there ever been any inhabitants on that planet, the planet Venus? Or are there inhabitants there now? Well, quite different than the Earthlings, it would have to be, I guess.
You may be able to find microbial entities or existence on the planet, but no, there is no higher life form there. But there is some life form. It's a very hostile environment for any higher beings to be in.
Would
But
it
it has been totally different in the past. And you also have to understand that the way the solar system is ordered in now, it was totally different from the beginning. The outer gas planets were more close to the solar, the sun from the
understood.
beginning. And the order has changed, and also some smaller bodies have been flung out into the universe.
How does the order change in planets? That could, is are you allowing Lars to actually see that occurrence, or could you see, let him see the occurrence in your visual?
It has to do with gravitation and the density of the body. It has also to do with the centrifugal forces.
Understood.
So the lighter, even though the gas formation in your solar system has a larger mass, but the density is not so high. So it was possible for them to change place with the more rockier planets that are closer to the sun today.
Interesting. Thank you very much. Now, the next planet that I was interested in, that we were interested in, was Saturn. They say that the rings of Saturn, or we've been told, or it's, you know, there's lots of things that are said here or in this dimension on this planet in this linear expression, that the rings of Saturn were made, artificially made. And actually, they were supposedly a weapon. What are
No,
those?
it's just remnants from the creation that's in that rings. It's just remnants that not been absorbed by the forces from the planet, because they are placed in such way that they can be orbiting forever.
So they're natural.
Yes,
Are
it's
there
remnants from the beginning.
any life forms on that planet, on Saturn?
The only planet that for the moment is carrying any higher life form is the planet Earth. But there are visiting on every planet, but mostly the rocky planets.
You say visiting as in extraterrestrials or extra dimensionals?
Extra-dimensional sometimes visit the outer planets made up of gas because they are not bound to any physical body. So they can dwell there
And
and stay there.
when they're there dwelling in a place like that, what would the purpose of that particular, they could create anything that they desire with their thoughts, or in terms of.
They can use that energy that is in that celestial body to a good purpose. We're not able to go into details now, but they use it to change frequencies, to sending out vibration of knowledge and understanding.
Excellent. Understood. And the next planet that I was interested in was Jupiter. I did a QHHT session with a doctor here, and she said in 2045 that there was a colony that from the Earth that had settled on Jupiter. Are there habitable places on Jupiter, or will there be in?
No, there is no solid surface there.
How does that, you say this record, the records of all information, could, do you have the records of Lars and Ethan and Hank's, of our life there, our life that we're in now, our physical expressions there, here in this record, these records?
All is in this record.
So if you could look into Hank's records and see what we would call in our past, within the past 2 years, I was doing a quantum healing hypnosis therapy session with a client. I'd not like to say her name. I just know she's a doctor, and she said there was a colony on Jupiter in 2045. What would make her say something like that? Or why would she get the impression that she was there? Could you access that, please? And if you could show Lars as well while doing so?
We can perceive that there is a misinterpretation of the place and the planet, that she misplaced the colony. But we can see that timeline.
You can? You can or cannot?
Cannot.
So how is that possible that you have the records of everything there, but yet you can't you can't see that?
Because it's not happening.
Oh. That's interesting. So how does that happen in our physical, how does a memory, or how does she access something, how does that happen where she was so misinterpreted her experience?
You have to understand that the knowledge we have here is from the record of what your missions and what your intent is during this life and has been in the past. Not every detail, but we can say that this entity you're talking about has been involved in several lifetimes before and may have been visiting this planet in another frequency and misinterpret that. That's what we can see.
Understood. Well, my intention doing that particular session, what she was told at the end of the session it was to give her hope for her future. My intentions every time that I do these sessions are to expand individuals' consciousness so they can see that they're more than what they thought they were before they came into these sessions. And so
she has had more experience before, and she will have a lot of more experience after. And this lifetime, she will experience a lot of changes going on, and that she will resonate to with her heart, and so will many of you on this planet. The changes is in work now, but you will not dwell in despair. That is just a big hindering energy in your development.
Understood. Well, I was just so basically what she was able to access or to able to see. They said it was to give her hope. Was that session in her best interest, even though she perceived it quite differently than what it actually was, what it was?
It was made in that form to give her the opportunity to understand. And yes, it was in her best interest. And it will go well for that lady.
Oh, very good. Very, very good. That's really good to hear. I don't think she'll ever hear this message. I don't want to call her and tell her to take a listen in, but there are others who have listened to the message because it's posted, and it gives them a larger understanding, even themselves, as they listen. While we're on the subject, and since I'm going to ask one more thing about the solar system, but I, since we're having this conversation now, and you just made a huge, you clarify a misconception. When we're doing these sessions, and you look into my records, and you, Hank's records, Henry Jones II, and you know what my intentions are, or what my missions are, you say, all of that information is there. Is that correct?
Are you talking about this lifetime?
This particular lifetime, this particular mission, even what we're doing now, you're familiar with what we're doing, are you? Yes?
We are familiar that you try to create messages to try to let people see that there is other purposes that what they have in front of their eyes, yes.
Well, I'm not trying to create the message. I'm actually trying to just get the message. And I know there's a language.
Spread the message.
Yeah, there's a language barrier. So I understand that between myself and Lara. So forgive me.
No problem at all.
So as you look.
We also have a wish to clarify.
Oh, please.
But you have to understand that we use your friend. We have to use part of his mind to be able to control his vocal cords and talk to you. So there can be some misunderstanding sometimes, because we cannot alter his mind. But he is not in his density present here now. He is somewhere else.
Is he working multidimensionally yet again?
He always takes the chance to raise his knowledge. And we give it to him also, so yes.
Oh, very good. Well, I'll just shift the conversation back to the solar system. And we are very grateful for all the information. And I tend to say that over and over, but I want to make sure, I know you heard it the first time. There's an asteroid belt where there's a bunch of asteroids. It's a huge ring in our solar system. How was that created?
You have two different places in your solar system. There are a lot of particle assembled, and it's due to gravitation forces and centrifugal forces. The most of the part in that that area you're talking about is icy particle that, if it has a higher speed and a different trajectory into the solar system, it should be almost like a comet. But there is not enough material or mass to create a planet of that. It should then, in that case, be a very, very little planet, very small planet.
Well, that's interesting, because I didn't mention anything about a planet. But do you know that what my next question is, or are you perceiving where I'm going with the what's what I'm how are you
you're talking with us often, and we are in the place of knowledge.
Ah, very good. So excellent. So basically, was there a planet? Actually, you just said it, but I'll just ask it straight out. And so if you could answer from the knowledge, was there a super planet that exploded or something to that effect and created those asteroid belts, or no?
No. There is not enough mass to come from any exploding planet. There is not enough mass to create a body big enough. It will not even come up to the standard of your own moon. If you put all of that materials together, it will be much smaller than your moon. It's so that if any planet should explode or had exploded, the density inside a planet is very, very high. The energy flow inside the planet is also very high. So should it explode, it will just vaporize, and there would be nothing left, almost like small dust particles.
So thank you. Thank you very much. We appreciate this information. Are you familiar with the technique that we're using? It's called quantum healing hypnosis therapy, developed by a woman named Dolores Cannon, an entity from the planet Earth that has recently passed in the past 2 years. And this is how we're not using quantum healing hypnosis. Hank, I basically developed a method to induce Lars to have this communication. Is it possible that any information that you're giving us from this these records could be infiltrated, and could you give us information that is false? Or present information that is false? Would there be a reason for that?
No, because if we have information that we don't want you to know about, we will not share it in this timeline. But of course, in some lower frequency, it can be altered by your mind, by your thoughts. But now in this frequency, you are not even present with your mind. So no, why should we ever lie to you?
I don't think that you lie to us at all. But for you know what my mission is, and you know what we're doing in this scenario. Lars is induced, and I'm asking questions, and I know we're in a high vibration. You said it from the beginning, the 11th dimension, or is that right? 11th dimension or vibrational? How do you, could you explain that, please?
We can say that we are in the 11th dimension, and there's a lot more dimension.
Oh, very good. Understood.
But it's a very high vibrating frequency of just pure energy, and can take whatever form it wants. And we're doing this work with you because you have the intent to spread knowledge. So we have no interest in to deceive anybody with any false information. We want you to understand clearly what we are saying, and clearly we understand what your intention is. So if you're not were on the right path with the right set of your mind and heart, so to speak, we should not have this conversation with you at all.
Ah, very good. And do you understand why, the reason why, of course I know you do, but I don't know, I just have to say it, on why I put the questions to you the way that I do?
We understand that there's a lot of person that feel insecure in all the messages they get from many entities of your planet. Some of them are good, some of them are not. But we have put this forward to you before.
Yes.
That you have to use your inner knowledge through your intuition to separate the false information from the right information, because there is a lot of false information out there, and almost all of it originates from the feeling of fear for the unknown. The fear is a big factor in the human's history and has been triggered